an adventure game in Python. During the adventure, we're going to ask our player some questions and they're going to make a decision on what to do, and we're going to design the different outcomes. So to begin the game, we need to set up a few basic things like a score, some lives, and also a bag so they can put various objects in and out. You can tailor your game how you wish. Okay, you can generally follow mine, or you can create your own scenarios, but following the code outline. Okay, so we're going to begin by setting up some variables. I'm going to use stylized comments like this to make it really easy for me to spot what I'm doing and where I am in my code, because the code could get quite long by the end of these videos. So here we go, let's have some lives. Let's have three lives, and let's have a score that will begin as a zero. And then let's create a rucksack. We'll use a list for the rucksack, so it's square brackets, and we're going to add three things: a key, a duck, and a brush. But you can add three random things of your own, and of course you can go back and change them later if you have inspiration. Super, so we've just got our basic setup there ready for the rest of the game. So let's welcome our player into the game. So we're going to use an input to ask what their name is. So name equals input brackets welcome. Let's just ask the game a name. What is your name? And then I'm going to use a colon and a space before my quotation mark so that there is a nice neat input when we run it. And then we're going to use their name. So we're going to say print statement welcome, comma, name, comma, to the adventure. Okay, so we've got a little welcome there now as well. Don't forget to put your comments either side. Now, let's start the game. So we need to come up with some kind of first scenario that they're going to wake up from or enter the game into. So I've got one on my clipboard prepared earlier. So I'm just going to do a little print statement here and I'm going to paste it in. Now, on mine, it is wrapping around like this. However, on yours, it'll be all the way over here, disappearing off the edge. Okay, if you write a long piece of text. So, a little trick to show you how to wrap some text around a long piece of text is, instead of using single quotations, you're going to use triple quotations. So, I'm just going to add two more quotations here, and also two more quotations here. Okay, doesn't look very much different, but that means that I can do things like this. I can add a couple of returns in the middle and stylize it a bit more like that. So when I run it, it'll look a bit like this. So what is your name? Bob. Welcome, Bob, to the adventure. You wake to the sound of an old crane cooking in her pot. She is singing an old song about cooking. I think she's about to cook you. And that's all in one print statement rather than three. So that's the basics of what we need. And then follow the next video for what to do next.